Hello, children, P7 candidates, Trinity Primary School 2020. How are you? You have been away from school for all this time. I don't know how you are spending this time. We are also here thinking about you. So we have come up with this program to record the lessons so that you can access them on the internet. So I'm here with SST. I'm teaching the syllabus, and please take it serious. We shall be following up to see whether you're really doing the work. Write the work in your books and even the exercise at the end, do it. When we come back, when the government opens schools, we shall just continue with the syllabus. We shall not repeat what we have taught now. So take it serious. I remember before we broke off due to coronavirus, I was teaching vegetation in both streams. And I'm sure in both streams we had not yet reached this. I'd introduce in P7 West, we are almost finishing vegetation zones, but in P7 East, we had just started. So the topic is it was vegetation in Africa, and we are discussing the factors affecting vegetation distribution. The factors affecting vegetation distribution. We are discussing why does Africa have very many types of vegetation? Why don't we have only one type of vegetation? Yet it is one continent. But you find we have all the types. If you can remember, equatorial forests, mangrove forests, temperate grasslands, tropical grasslands, all those are in Africa. Why is Africa divided into those many types of vegetation? Why not only one type of vegetation? The same can apply for Uganda. Why does Uganda have very many types of vegetation, not only one type of vegetation? So the reasons why Africa has very many types of vegetation, why Uganda has very many types of vegetation, are the ones we call factors affecting vegetation distribution. So when they ask you to give the factors affecting vegetation distribution, they are asking you to give the reasons why Africa has many types of vegetation. And the reasons are here listed. One of the reasons is climate or rainfall. The other one is fertility of the soil. The other one is human activities, what we commonly call man's activities. Then lastly, altitude. So each of these reasons, you must be able to explain how does it make vegetation to be different? And at the end of the lesson, I'll put an exercise. I'm going to tell you here, so you must be very attentive. This lesson is on the internet. You can even replay. You have that option of replaying it, and you get my explanation so that when you reach the exercise, you can get the answer. Now, climate. How does climate or rainfall affect vegetation distribution? How does climate make Africa not to have the same type of vegetation? So here what we shall say is, places which receive much rainfall have more vegetation than places which have little rainfall. The more the rainfall, the more the vegetation. The less the rainfall, the less the vegetation. That's why you see places which receive a lot of rainfall in Africa, like DRC, like Congo Brazzaville. When you go to those countries, you find dense, heavy forests. Why do they have such thick forests? It's because they receive too much rain. And when you go to deserts where there is no rainfall, you will not find there any vegetation. So, how does climate affect vegetation distribution? Places with good climate have more vegetation than places with poor climate. If you want to use rainfall, you say places with much rainfall have more vegetation than places with less rainfall. So that one is finished. That's how climate affects vegetation distribution. Then when we go to fertility of the soil, I'm very sure all of you know that vegetation can't grow without soil. So the more fertile the soil is, the more vegetation we shall have in an area. So there we shall say, places with fertile soil have more vegetation than places with poor soil. In areas where the soil is fertile, you find there a lot of vegetation. Where the soil is not fertile, you find there little or no vegetation. So how does fertility of the soil affect vegetation? Places with fertile soils have more vegetation than places with poor soil. Then man's activities or human activities. Man can affect vegetation distribution. There are some activities of man which can destroy the vegetation. Then there are other activities of man which can support or can preserve or can conserve the vegetation. I'm very sure this is very easy for you because even in lower classes it is taught. So here, what will you say? How do human activities affect vegetation distribution? You just say, some activities of man support vegetation while other activities of man destroy vegetation. So here you must know the examples of activities which support vegetation and the examples of activities which destroy vegetation. So some of the activities of man which support vegetation, you can mention activities like afforestation, reafforestation, swamp conservation, zero grazing, agroforestry. Those are good activities. If man carries out those activities, the vegetation will be there. But there are other activities of man which can destroy the vegetation. Deforestation is bad, destroys vegetation. Swamp drainage destroys vegetation. Overgrazing destroys vegetation. So where man has good activities, vegetation will be preserved. Where man has bad activities, vegetation will be destroyed. So some activities of man support vegetation, while other activities of man destroy vegetation. Then lastly, altitude. When we are learning about climate, we defined what altitude is. Altitude is the height of land above the sea level. Altitude makes temperatures. It affects temperature. The higher you go, the cooler it becomes. The higher you go, the higher you go on a higher altitude, temperature drops. On a low altitude, the temperature is low. Areas on a low altitude are warm. Areas on a high altitude are cold. So how does that change in temperature affect vegetation? So how does that difference in temperature brought by altitude affect vegetation? At a low altitude, where temperatures are warm, warm temperatures support more vegetation compared to cold temperatures. So places on a low altitude have more vegetation because of warm temperature, while places on a high altitude have little vegetation due to cold temperature. Places on a low altitude are warm, and therefore they have more vegetation than places on a high altitude which are cold. Cool temperature does not support too much vegetation. So that is part one of the lesson. First of all, since we are in P7, we are preparing for exams. Once in a while, we remind you how these things we teach appear in exams. They can bring a question. Mention three reasons why Africa has very many types of vegetation. There they are asking you factors affecting vegetation distribution. Other question can come direct. Mention three factors affecting vegetation distribution in Africa. There you just mention them. But also the examiner can be tricky and asks you to explain, to test, did you understand when the teacher was teaching? So they will ask you, how does climate affect vegetation distribution? How does fertility of the soil affect vegetation distribution? How do human activities affect vegetation distribution? How does altitude affect? And that one, that is what I did for you. That is the end of that part. Now, under vegetation, we are also supposed to study how vegetation affects animals. Because in each vegetation zone in Africa, you find there a special type of animals which live there. In the forest, you find there are monkeys, you find there are chimpanzees, mountain gorillas. They live in forests. In the grasslands, you find there are animals which eat grass. Zebras, buffaloes. But you also find there are lions. A lion lives in grass, yet it doesn't eat grass. So you must know the reason. So we can be asked to explain why animals live in different vegetation zones. In my next lesson, we shall give examples of all the animals and each vegetation zone and the animals which are found there. But why do those animals live in those vegetation zones? Why does a monkey live in a forest? Why does a zebra live in a grassland? The reason is due to presence of food. Animals go to a vegetation which will provide them food. That's why a buffalo is in a grassland, because it wants to eat the grass. A monkey is on a tree because it feeds on the fruits and the leaves. That's why it is in the forest. A lion is found in a grassland, not because it eats grass, but because it wants to eat those grass-eating animals. Then another reason why animals live in different vegetation zones is due to presence of shelter. Animals are attracted to a vegetation zone that gives them shelter, where to stay. And lastly, due to presence of comfort and safety. The vegetation zone, the type of vegetation which makes an animal comfortable and safe, that's where you'll find it. So a monkey is safe and comfortable in a tree. That's why you find it in forests. You will not find it in grassland, because it is not comfortable and safe there. So reasons why animals live in different vegetation zones: due to presence of food, the food they eat attracts them to that vegetation zone, due to presence of shelter, and due to presence of comfort and safety. We are also going to learn about how to care for wild animals. Most of us are used to domestic animals which we have at home, and we know how to care for them. But even animals in game parks can be cared for. How can we care for them? One, feeding them. Two, treating them when they are sick. There are doctors who go to those animals and they treat them. Three, preserving their habitat, making sure habitat means a home, making sure the homes where they stay are not destroyed. That's why the government tells us not to destroy forests, because that is a home for monkeys. Game parks are homes for all those animals. So when you preserve game parks, you have cared, because that's the home for those animals. Then lastly, protecting them, making sure we don't kill them unnecessarily. We protect them. So this is the lesson I prepared for you. I have organized for you an exercise which is from this lesson. The answers to this exercise are from what I've been saying. So we shall check on you to see if you have done the exercise. Remember, when you come back, when the term opens, when the government opens schools, we shall not teach this work again. We expect you to have learned it through the internet. We are in modern times these days. We call it homeschooling. We are studying from home. So the work, how do each of the work is here. They can display it for you on the camera. You copy. If you feel you don't remember anything, just to replay my lesson. All the answers are in the words I've been saying. How does climate affect vegetation? How does soil fertility affect vegetation? How does altitude affect vegetation? How do man's activities affect vegetation? Then on the other side, we also have mentioned two reasons why animals live in different vegetation zones. The reasons are there in the lesson we have had. Mentioned two activities of man that can destroy vegetation. Those ones, I mentioned them. And the two activities of man that can destroy vegetation. Thank you. Be serious, children. We, the teachers, are on tension. We are thinking about you. Please cooperate with us and follow these lessons. Wait for another lesson from me. Thank you very much.